Hi everyone, in this video I am going to answer to some questions so generally the students have when they start the GATE preparation. The first, maybe, what is the right time to start GATE preparation? Well, generally the students will think, so when do we start or when, what is the right time to start the GATE preparation? And also if you have so many questions, I think these are some basic questions. So when do we start the GATE preparation to get a good plan, etc. How many months we need to prepare or we need to spend right in the preparation. Then how many hours do we need to spend per day, right? So that is also a big question. So people ask, so 4 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, is a, so how many hours do we need to actually spend per day? Now this one is somewhat so funny question. That is, will I get a good rank if I prepare well, right? So many students will have this one. So if I work hard, so will I get a good rank or not, right? See, for this question, so don't estimate or don't underestimate yourself, or don't think about the results when you don't started the preparation, or even when you're writing in the exam, before the exam, don't think about the results. Just concentrate on your preparation, right? So that is, even if you don't, if you not started the preparation, now you are thinking about the results, right? So will I get a rank or not, etc. So unless until you finish the GATE exam, don't think about that one, right? Because we need to go across the hardest battles when you are going with the preparation. So many battles are there. That is, each subject, each topic is like a battle for you, right? For us. So you have to win those battles to prepare very well for the last battle, that is the GATE exam, right? So you have to think like that, and you have to win each and every battle when you're preparing, right? So in this lecture I'm going to give my strategies. So that is, everyone may inspired from these strategies or may not, but the one who can follow this strategy or follow this strategy, you will get the results. There is no doubt at all, right? So just go through this, then and if you have any question, you can ask. Now see, you have to prepare or something means, so first you have to inspire from something, right? So who is your inspiration, right? My inspiration is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, right? And not only me, millions of people in this India, this country, or around the world also, right? So take one idol person. When you see that person, you should get some, you should get inspiration, not motivated. The motivation is part time, the inspiration is long time, right? So what you need, you have to decide. So you get some inspiration from the greatest persons, then start anything, because you have to achieve a big in this, suppose in this case, maybe GATE exam, it may be any competitive exam. So this is the, once you achieve this this greatest thing, so the your life will be different, right? So that's why you have to get inspired from the greatest persons, right? So I started this channel because I inspired from the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, how we inspired so many, the millions of people in this country are old. That is some inspiration I got to start this channel and sharing my knowledge to the students, right? And to inspire them to achieve something in this in their career, right? Career, etc. So that we'll see in the, I'm going to answer some questions, right? So what is the right time, when, how many hours do we need to really spend, etc. That we have to see, right? So we have to categorize the students first, right? So first I will categorize the students like this. Suppose we are having only 10% of basics, right? So I will go with this generalized students. So suppose if we are in the third year or fourth year, so that we'll categorize next. First we will go for the, suppose at least some students will have at least 10% basics. Then next category is, suppose maybe 30%, 40%. So I will go with the something like this. Suppose if we are having a 50% basics, right? So generally less than this, but some fellows, that is who already given the GATE exam, right? Who already given GATE. So we have to categorize something like this. So I think this is should not go for this 50% basics, more than 10 to 50% in that range, and who already given some, I mean already given GATE exam, something like this. So you may be prepared or you have taken coaching, etc. Now, so what is the right time or how many months required? Suppose if you know at least the subjects wise, suppose how many subjects are there, at least you should know some basics, right? That is 10%. The minimum required GATE preparation is 6 months. 6 months, or if I go with some extension, suppose if you are now a slow learner, so can go to 6 to 8 months, right? So not more than that. So that 6 to 8 months, if you prepare very well, so you can achieve a good rank. 6 months is the 6 to 8 months is the time to get a good rank. You can achieve a good rank, right? Next, this one is 10 to 50% basics, etc. If you are going for this self-study, so this 50% basics, if you know, so you can go for this self-study. This 6 to 8 months with our 10% basics, if you have to take some guidance from, if you are going for self here, so you have to take guidance from the some your teachers or some online coaching, etc. And you can go for offline coaching, so that's very good. We are having so many institute, but that depends on your financial status, etc. Now if you are having 50% basics, that means you are doing well in your academics, then this I can go with 3 to 4 months, right? So 3 to 4 months is sufficient to get achieve a good rank in GATE exam. Now if someone has already written the GATE exam, right, so I have to categorize again this 3 to 4 months only, because 50% basic, so you can restrict to 3 months, right? So this is this is my strategy or my analysis, right? So 6 months is good enough. This is 3 to 4 months and 3 months enough for the to get a good rank. Now in six months or 3 to 4 months or 3 months, how many hours we need to spend each day, right? That is also depend, but I can go like this. Suppose if you start initially either one or two subjects, so don't go beyond 3 to 4 hours, or I will go with 4 to 5 hours, right? So 4 to 5 hours, that is, or concepts 2 hours, or maybe more than that, 3 hours, and practice for remaining hours. So I'll go with this is 3 hours, this is 2 hours, right? So in these 3 hours you can prepare 2 subjects, and in this 2 hours you can go for practice for two subjects again, right? So that is at least 4 to 5 hours for each day we have to spend, and initially for 3 months. Now remember, this 4 to 5 hours should be continuous for your this 6 months. It's not like that you prepared for 1 month or 2 months, like 10 hours, 8 hours, then the remaining 1 month you will be somewhat taking rest, etc. So that should not happen. This 4 to 5 hours you spend continuously, regularly for these 6 months. There is no hurdle to stop you or to get a achieve good rank, right? So that is for sure, right? So next one is this 3 to 4 months who is preparing. So again, so we have to get at least 5 to 6 hours for this only if you are going, I mean, if you're not having any classes or if you are already completed BTech, so you can go to 5 to 6 hours initially, then you can spend more than this after 1 month or 2 months, right? So this is 5 to 6 hours. Then yeah, in this already you have given gate, so you are having some knowledge, and you have to do only practice, right? So in these 3 months, so you have to do this 6 to 7 hours, etc. We have to go that continuously. You have to leave 6 to 7 hours. So if you do, so what is this per day? Suppose 6 hours you are spending for 3 months, right? So per each day 6 hours, so 180 hours, so 180 into 3, so approximately 550 hours you are spending for 3 months. So 500 to 600 hours is sufficient to get or to crack any competitive exam, right? Which is related to the technical. As if you are having non-technical also like IAS, so we need some time. Depend only 10 subjects, then this is enough. 500 to 600 hours is enough. Now, apart from this, what you are learning, the main thing is the test series, right? So you have to do or take this test series before the main exam. Then this one is only the what is the feedback it will give, right? So you are doing something now, you should have some feedback, say how your performance is there. So that is a test series. This you can go before 1 month or 2 months, etc. Right? This is some strategy, right? That's a 6 month, 3 to 4 month, 3 months. Now, so suppose now again, there are three categories. The students will be three categories, that is, who are in third year or the final year students, right? So we'll go with like this: third year, maybe second year also no problem. So when final year, so fourth year, and who have completed the your BTech completed fellows. Now, so how to manage your timings, like 4 to 5 hours, etc. Now, if you are going for your college, so you have to split this 4 to 5 hours, or you can go 2 hours or 4 hours per day continuously. Now, split 2 hours in the morning. So morning means at least you have to wake up at 5 o'clock. So do it your preparation for 2 hours. Then, so morning 2 hours, evening 2 hours, right? So this will be applicable for who is going for either third year, second year, or final year. So we have to spend this 4 hours per day. So you have to divide this 4 hours. So morning 2 hours, evening 2 hours, etc. So morning you study the only concepts. Then when you come in the evening, so you have to practice with those concepts. Just 10, I mean 10 to 15 minutes to revise those concepts. Again, you have to do the practice. Then when you who completed already the BTech, so what you have to do is go for this 4 hours in the morning itself, right? So morning itself you study this 4 hours, right? And suppose if you are going for any, I mean courses, etc. So morning 4 hours, this morning you spend 4 hours for preparation as well as, I mean, the concepts as well as the practice purpose. Right? In the evening, you can start the different subject, that is, which is not technical. You can go for general aptitude for one, right? So that is for completed fellows who are already completed. And my suggestion is, suppose if you are completed, and if you think that you are only giving for gate exam, then don't think for other. That is, generally people will think, I will go, I mean, I will study for IAS, or first I will study for gate, then I will go with the IAS, etc. So they prefer, or they step in two paths, right? So simultaneously they will see some other courses they will join, like Java, .NET, etc. If you fix a goal, that is, you have to fix in your mind that you have to achieve a good rank in gate exam, right? Once you fix this goal, so in your mind it should be fixed for this 2018, suppose. So you should have no other thought beyond this gate exam. So only you have to think about the gate, right? So, and again, you should not be some, get some stress or depression, right? So, how to get, or if I don't do, etc. So, don't think about anything. First, we have to prepare. So, first, we have to give our best. So, to give our best, we need to prepare best, right? So, how to prepare best? So, we are having so many methods, right? So, if you are not comfortable with this, there are so many online lectures by so many, the best faculty. They have given so many strategies. So you can follow one strategy. If you are following that strategy, there is no one to stop to get a good rank. Then, so that is strategy means you have to follow that one. So for 1 month, you are very motivated. Then you started preparation. After 1 month, so some fellows think that so this concept somewhat difficult, etc. So they will take light, right? That also I will discuss now. No, it should not be like that, right? You should have very confident on how much you are studying or how you are studying. Once you get confidence, this that's why I have given this initially 4 to 5 hours, or at least you can go for 2 hours at least to get confidence. Once you get the confidence, then there is no one to stop to go beyond the limitations, right? So that is required here, the confidence on the subjects. That's why whatever the subject you are very good at, or you are having some passion about that subject, you start those subjects in no starting. It may be mathematics, right? It may be network theory. It may be signals and systems, or digital electronics, or EDC, electronic devices and circuits. Maybe AEC or communication, or anything. Whatever the subject you are, even if you are good at this aptitude, general aptitude, right? Quant. You start with that, get some confidence, then go, right? So that is about that one. Now, I'll give some statistics. In GATE 2017 in EC branch, right? Or so this is not only for EC branch. So that is, I think, generalized. So overall GATE. So but I'll go with this EC. In EC, total number of appeared candidates are 1,41,665. 1,41,665, right? Approximately 1,42,000. Now, in this 1,41,665, the number of qualified students, that qualified means the different categories for different marks. So I'll go with the 25 marks. Suppose for 100 marks, 25 is the qualifying marks. So only 17 or maybe 20,000. So even if I go for 20,000, only 12%. Right, so 12% is 17,000. So if I go with some more, that is 20,000. From 1,42,000, so only the qualifying students are only 20,000, nearly 20,000, right? So I have taken only 12%. So maybe 15% or 13% we can take. So assume this is 20,000. Now see where the 1,22,000 or 1,21,000 are going. Right, so that is required here, some guidance to those students, the remaining students. That's why I'm making this video, to guide the remaining students, so to proper direction. Right, now so that is this statistics. So it may be varies, but this one is fixed. So because I have written the GATE exam, so I know how many number of candidates appeared in GATE 2017. So that is 1,41,665. Right, so approximately 20,000 only 20,000 will be qualified, and in only that 20,000, maybe below 1,000, so it is very less, maybe 1,000, 2,000, etc. Right, that also we discuss. And this one I already discussed rank wise. This is for EC again, EC branch only, marks wise and rank wise. So someone has shared these marks. So for 54 marks, he got 937 rank, and who got 57, he got 608 rank. And someone shared me that is approximately 50 marks, he got 1567 rank, right? And This is also approximate only, he told. That is for 82 to something, so he got second rank, and approximately 85 the first rank. And my rank was, so I got 44.85 marks, and this was 2737, right? So this is some ranks wise and marks wise. Now, so what is my session is, now you have chosen something to preparation or etc. So this is you. So you will have two paths. One is, so one path will leads to you, so this 1,22,000 members, that is, so this whatever I'm saying, this has taken who has already given something, it is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He said, you want to be you or everybody else. So this 1,21,000 is here, 1,22,000 I'll go, 1,22,000. So it will lead to this everybody else. And there is one more path which will lead to some uniqueness, right? So this is some unique people leads to the second path. So it may be less than 1500 or less than 1000. I will go with the less than 1000 rank. So another path will be there. So we don't require that one, right? So depending on your strategy, your practice, so that may be less than 100, less than 10, less than, I mean, the first rank also you can get, right? So what, so my inspiration is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So I inspired by him. I read books by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, right? So I know some famous quotations. I'm going to read those also. Now this one, so once you fix your goal, right, so there is two paths. So this will lead to, so everybody else, so this is 1,22,000 people. So in this 20,000 or approximately 17,000, so there should be some uniqueness, that is less than 1000, less than 500, less than 100, etc. Now, so you want to be you or unique or somebody else or everybody else, right? So is in this. Now, what is the strategies? What is the preparation strategies required is, so whatever I discussed, if you follow that, so you'll become into this unique people, right? Now, so that is about this one, the strategy, what is the statistics, and how you prepare. So you have to fix your goal and you have to work on that, right? Now I'll give some quotation. So what the famous quotation by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam: learning gives creativity, creativity leads to thinking, thinking provides knowledge, knowledge makes you great as well as the nation, right? So this quotation is given by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So the moment you start learning, so you can things like creativity manner. Once you are creating, so it leads to thinking. The moment you are thinking, so that it will provide you knowledge. Once you got the knowledge, so you can become a great, right? So many great persons in the nation, so and the nation also will become great, right? So that is one famous quotation. That's why keep learning, continuous learning will makes you great, right? So that is one quotation. So one more is, this is very important. So many people think that so many fellows will ask, sir, my percentage or the BTEC percentage is 60%, maybe 50%. So can I prepare for GATE exam or will I get a job? 100% you can get a good rank. Reason is, so in GATE 2017, right, the first ranker in ECE, he only said, he got the VTEC percentage is only approximately 62 to 65%. I don't remember exact, 60 to 65%. Now in GATE 2017, first ranker, the percentage was 60 to 65%. There is no relates any percentage to this GATE rank. That depends on your knowledge, how much knowledge you are gaining, how much concepts you are gaining, how much practice you are doing, how much hard work you are doing. That depends on your GATE performance, not like your BTEC performance, right? So that is, I'm giving this quotation. Now, all of us do not have an equal talents, right? So everyone will have different talents, but all of us have an equal opportunities to develop our talents. Again, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Now, so this quotation is very, you know, applicable to the so many students, right? They'll think that, so I'm not having that talent, etc., etc. They say, so everybody will not have an equal talents, right? Someone will have, you know, passion about some mathematics. So someone will have different kind of, so someone is good at programming, someone good at, you know, communications, etc. So, but there is a path. All of us have an equal opportunities. So you will have same opportunities to develop our talents, right? So are you using those opportunities to develop your talent? That is important, right? Once you utilize those opportunities, you can become a great person, right? So that is, you have to remember, right? So, and he said one more quotation. See, you cannot change your future, but you can change your habits. But the surely these habits will change your future, right? So you have to change your habits to change your future, right? So those habits you have to, you know, habituate regularly. So by starting tomorrow or today itself, I said, only this, the percentage of qualifying is some only 20%, 12%, and 122,000 are, no, even not qualifying, only 17,000 or 20,000 is qualifying. So what may be the reason, right? You know, if you are in this, so did you question yourself, why I am in this region, right? Why not in this? Now, why generally, so I mean, the students who are joining the coaching, etc., the 90% or 70 to 80% or 85% are joined like this, like that only, so without any proper goal or etc. So they will start, we have to do something, so maybe from the parent side or etc., so they will just join the coaching center, and only they go for the coaching, they will listen, and they just listen and they don't do any practice, etc., right? The remaining 5 to 10% or 5 to 7%, etc., what they will do is they go for coaching or they prepare for themselves. But after before the 2 months or 1 month gate exam, they start thinking that I may not get a good rank in the exam or gate exam, so they start thinking in that negative manner, negative side. So in that 5 to 10%, they lose just qualifying, just maybe 25 marks to 30 marks, 35 marks, they will enter into that range, right? The remaining only the competition will be between only the this 141,000, the main competition between only 10,000 people, 10,000 students only. This 80% will be gone like that, right? So there is no proper dreams or proper goals for this 85% students. Only this 15% students will have no goal, and they will be dropped out in between. Some people though thinking in a different some people will come in between, they will go for we are preparing for some softwares, etc., or we are going for some banks and POs, etc. So this 5 to 10% will have so many in their mind, so many paths, so many thinking will be there, that I should go for banks, or I should go for civils, or I should go for IES, etc., right? The remaining only 5 to 10% or 7 to 8% will think only one thing, that is only gate, and they prepare only for that, they practice only for that. So the high competition will be between 10,000 only. Where is 141,000? Where is only 10,000, right? That is the variation actually is happening because you know lack of motivation. Like, I know it should not be motivation. We should not say motivation. It should be inspiring. They should not know inspired by something. They just go like that only. Now for those students, what my suggestions is, before starting your preparation, you have to fix your goal. Right? Now, without any dream or goal, you should not go further, right? Once you fix that, you have to work very hard to achieve that goal, right? And see, there is only 6 months. If this 6 months, you are only thinking about this goal without thinking anything, that is, it may be Facebook, it may be WhatsApp, it may be etc., etc. No, in between some of these 25% people, suppose if you are doing your coaching, taking coaching, and in between some festivals are there, something is there in your home or some functions are there, it just go like that. That should not happen for this 6 months. Once you achieve your goal, you can do anything. See, if you are only for your entire life, if you prepare very well in this 6 months, if you fix your goal and if you achieve this goal, the entire life will be different, right? So how many students are thinking like that, right? So very less, 10%, 5%, right? Maybe less than that. So that is actually lacking here. This 1,22,000 people are lacking some, the goals, right? So you have to fix your goal. So very, they take very light actually, right? So nothing is there. So I'll suggest you the guest lectures by the Ravindra Babu Raula is very good at this, inspiring the students, the young youth, right? So you should, if you are not taking the challenges now, the technology is going to lead you. If you are not going to take or learning those technologies, you will be doomed, right? So I will suggest you to go watch those videos. So he will be inspiring the students, right? Even I also inspired from that. So then only I started these lectures to share my knowledge, right? So that is the reason. So see, you are wasting so much time. From that wasting time, just take some time to prepare this one. So I just told to only 4 to 5 hours is enough. So if you are charting day and night, so what is the achievement? You are achieving something? I don't think so. Just think about that and start doing something different. See, you are doing like what everybody else is doing, right? So everybody is like charting Facebook, etc., etc. Now where is the uniqueness in you? So it should be in a different, see, 100 people are doing in WhatsApp, the only 10% people will be doing in a different thing. So why should not be in that? Why this 1,22,000 people are failing? Because of only these things. They don't take very serious the goals, right? Only they're doing in a busy with the machine. They're always, they will go with some machine, right? Which is useless actually, right? That is technology leading you, not you have to lead the technology, not wise. That is, the technology is leading you, right? So that is the reason. You should not be everybody else. You should be you, only you, and you should be unique, right? So that is the lack of something in the present day students actually, right? But the present day students, their minds are very, very active, are very, very sharp compared to the previous generations, right? Once they listen, they get very quick, right? So I told my students, so they prepare before 1 hour or 2 hours before one day for the exam. Now why don't you study for at least 10 minutes every day? If you are preparing, see, I will also suggest this one. If you are at second year or third year, you try to study each subject 10 minutes after the class in your day, just 10 minutes revision. See the results in your coming days or in exams, coming exam. 10 minutes each subject. What are the sir explain in the class? You do revision for 10 minutes that same concept. But again, I'm telling you should not revise 1 hour for whole 1 week. Whatever the sir told in that lecture, just revise on that day itself and see the results, right? Generally, people think that so why we only some concept is only told, so that we'll revise later. See, the moment that day we revise, it will be remembered so long. But if you revise after 10 days, so you have to spend 1 hour time to revise that concept because you forgot in that one, you forgot that one, right? So that is the very, very important for this, generation students, right? They, if you spend 10 minutes, it's very sufficient for your minds actually. So very, very active mind. So each subject 10 minutes, if you are having 6 subjects, 60 minutes is enough for each day. You can do wonders in the 60 minutes if you are spending instead of we are doing some other things like Facebook chatting, etc., etc. So think about this one, right? So who is going for this college, universities, going with doing their BTECs, etc., right? Not for the gate, right? So that is different. We have to spend at least 4 to 5 hours each day, right? Now we have to think about, so what we need to fix our goal, right? So this goal is important to achieve something. Now without any goal, so we cannot proceed or we cannot start our strategies or preparation. So for GATE preparation or preparing students, so you have to fix the first goal. So I'll think about something. Suppose if I post a video, suppose how to get a good rank or how to get a below few higher rank or first rank, etc. So generally people search for the tricks, generally tricks, shortcuts, how to get a good rank in short time, or generally they search for the very tricking methods, right? How to get easily, right? Easy ways. See, these videos or etc. is only some 5% inspiring you or etc. The main one who has adopt or something is one again you only, right? How many videos we make or someone is making and you're only watching and not doing anything, so you will not get any 500 or 100 rank. So that is only for if you prepare like that, you may get less than 500. But are you doing that thing what we are explaining? So question yourself, right? So again, you have to do on your own only. So we are making video and you're just watching, not doing anything, so no use, right? Right. So generally these videos, so we'll have so many views, etc., but that doesn't matter, you're only watching, right? So if you're without any, you're watching, once you fix your goal, so there is no need of any videos, right? Only you need some guidance, or you need a one mentor to guide you in a proper direction, right? Now that's why, so first we need to fix our goal, right? Now again, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam told one quotation, right? So you have to dream before your dreams come true, right? So without any dream, without any goal, so you cannot go further, right? So first you fix your goal, that is I should get 100th rank, right? I should get first rank, I should get second rank, or etc. So my aim is always we go for the first rank. Now what you have to do is in your reading room, so paste it on any paper, etc. So your name, and then next is your rank, the first rank. Now every day you have to see when you are studying, or when you are, know, when you are start to wake up, or etc. Always see the rank and tell to everyone, right? So I'm preparing for the GATE exam, so my aim is like this, right? Now once you start like this, so automatically you start your preparation, or you try to know go for this preparation, right? So you already given awards for your friends or your parents, etc. So there is some pressure on you. I have given, or I have told to my friends, I'm preparing for GATE and I am achieving, my goal is like this. So there is some pressure on you. Now that pressure will leads or motivates you or inspire you to study in a proper way, or perfect, we can say. So that is the, so first we have to fix our goal. Then what we need some proper guidance or proper strategy to achieve this rank, right? So without any proper path or proper strategy, we cannot achieve big things, right? So first one is goal. Then you have to think about that goal only each and every day, and not to be stressed. It should be some pressure on you, not to be stressed, right? So once you are getting stressing, means you'll get a bit depressed and you get into other modes, right? So it should not be like that, right? So in this 6 months, you have to think about this only, right? Then only you'll get. Now in 6 months, now there is so many ways to prepare, right? So you can go for GATE coaching, offline, online, etc. You can follow some free online videos to prepare yourself. The main thing is you have to start reading standard books, standard test books, right? Even though if so many teachers in GATE coaching centers, they give concepts from the textbooks only, but we have to read one more time, or at least we have to do practice problem from these textbooks only, right? So that will help you to solve problems very quick in GATE exam. They will not give repeated questions from previous GATE to the present or etc. They will make new problems based on the concepts only. But if you prepare only those concepts without any practice, so you may get you may not get that concept in the exam. That's why we have to start reading the standard test books, right? Now again, so about this one, goal is like this. So you have to go for like this only for 6 months, right? Now, so when do we start, or when the perfect time to each and every day is again? So I'll tell you, there is a lecture by the GATE teachers by Ravindra Babu Rawla, is there. So he'll give a lecture on why should we wake up early, right? So I will suggest you to watch that video, right? So early wake up is very helpful to achieve something. So go and watch that video, right? So that is why should we wake up early by Ravindra Babu Rawla. So he gives so many lectures, so inspiring the students, right, to do something, right? So that is so it's very helpful for you, for any student, right? Even it's not only about the student, everyone is required, right? So always we need to wake up early in the morning, so that we have to prepare, right? So again, then the what I suggest is, so fix your goal. I work on that, right? So fix your goal means it should not be like less than 500, etc. So you have to fix either first rank or 100th rank, etc., right? So work on that, you will achieve big, right? If your thinking is big, you will achieve big. If your thinking is like less than 500, less than 1000, so it should not be like that, right? So that is about this video. So if you are having any doubts, please post a comment, right? We can discuss. And one more thing I have to mention here is, So whoever is following my lectures, so we have to make a group. That is, so even if I know motivate or inspire at least 100 students, and I'm making all these videos only for sharing my knowledge. So I may be prepared for all the the topics or subjects. This 10 is there, so I may be preparing the 9 subjects videos, right? So even these 100 students are now benefited from this my knowledge. So that is very happy moment for me. So what I need from these 100 students is, please give your mail IDs. So we have to share our knowledge, right? How to do any problem with some easy or if you're not getting any question, how to solve. So we can post mail that, or you can chat in, we can make a WhatsApp group and we can discuss on that group only. And need, no, it should not be, it should be perfect, right? So each and every day you have to spend some time for this preparation. That is minimum is 4 hours, right? At least if you are starting tomorrow, start at least from for 2 hours tomorrow, then slowly for 1 week at least 2 hours, then increase the time for preparation, and so then you will get very good results, right? So please send your mail IDs, right? So, or you can make any question regarding what I am teaching. It may be now signals and systems, it may be EDC, AEC, etc. Whatever I know, I'm having knowledge, I can give you. If I'm not having, I will read and I'll try to solve those questions in an easy way, right? So, but don't worry. Now, some people think so we have to post videos of high volume, but actually, I'm making videos on my phone, right? So we need to make a video, we need to edit that video. Suppose some mistake is there, etc. So to make 30-minute video, I'm wasting approximately 1 hour, 2 hours. Sometimes it's 2 hours is not required this for 30 minutes or 40 minutes video, right? So that is actually I'm spending. But anyway, for a preparation also I need some more time, right? So anyway, I will post the 9 subjects what I promise to the students in easy way. So I'm sure if you follow my videos and some my notes and some questions, right, previous questions or from the textbook questions, with your effort, so I will assure you, you will achieve your goal, right? There is no doubt at all, because I have written 4 or 5 times the GATE exam. I know how to solve each and every concept, right? So if even if I written the GATE 2017 GATE exam, so each and every question I concept wise I know, but very fastness or etc. without practice, I gone to GATE 2017. I'm in a teaching profession, so apart from the subject I'm teaching, so I just sometimes I revision, sometimes I have taken test series, right? So without some regular preparation, so I got 44.85 marks, right? If it is like that, if you prepare for this 6 months, right, coming 6 months or 7 months, if you prepare for 3 months also, so you can imagine. And I forgot to mention, so what is your goal means, so this one, right? So there is 85 marks is our target, right? So to achieve this 85 marks, so it's not difficult, right? So it is not difficult, you can achieve easily. Now to achieve this 45 or this 50, 65 marks, it is easy, right? So easy in the sense you have to practice, right? Now if you practice some more, you may be reach this goal, right? So to achieve the 60 to 65 marks is easy, very easy, right? Only it requires the lot of practice. And if your practice is more than this, so and in that exam, and if very peace right, in your mind, etc. So if that is your day, so you may get this marks also. But that depends on that day, so that we'll discuss, you know, and not time being. But these two, 65 to 85, so it should be our goals, right? If you aim for this, at least we may get, you know, in between this also. So that's why we need to think big, right? So that is about this video. So if even I miss something, so please post a comment, we can discuss on that, right? Even if I know gone wrong in some way, so please post a comment, so I may be correcting, right, some these statistics or my strategy. If you are not good at my strategy, so it's no problem, so no need to, you know, follow this strategy only, but this one is very important, right? So start preparing now onwards, or at least from tomorrow onwards, you are now having setting goal. So there should not be postponing, right? So when you start, means you have to start by tomorrow itself, right? So good luck to everyone who is starting the preparation, right?